happening, you know, let it happen. The more you resist, it persists, according to me. You know, the more you want to stop it, you know, it keeps coming. Don't want to be positive, please. It's okay, it's fine to be negative.
Accept.
Listen, after acceptance, what happens, it goes away. The more you chase, na, it comes after you. Allow it to happen, it just goes away. So find the coming, come. Do whatever you want to do.
Yes, what Buddha says, when somebody is screaming at him, and you won't bother whether they are screaming at him or somebody else.
Yeah.
It was just silent.
Yeah.
So after some time they left, and then the sisters asked, how come you are sitting like this when they are scolding you so much? Then they are not scolding, they are scolding themselves.
Yeah.
Whatever they eat, it is for them. Whatever they listen, it is for them. Whatever they scold, also it is for them. So like that. That's what Buddha says.
Okay. If I take it, it is for me. If I don't take it,
it's for them only.
If you don't take insult, it is not yours.
Yeah.
Anything for that matter. If you take it, then one word of negative word has ruined your whole day. But not the 100 positive things that person has said. No, that you won't think. One negative word has said has pinched you so much. Because your electromagnetic aura is not very strong enough. When it becomes strong, no, you won't take it. It's not easy to actually develop. You start developing that.
Osho, one day he gives a talk. I think Ramesh was giving me. He gives a talk, he gives a statement which is a truth. The second day he will completely contradict that.
So make you think.
So it is a bundle of, people say Osho is a bundle of paradox.
Absolutely.
Life is a paradox. You need
like
both
that.
Polarities, okay?
The mic is changing every now and then. Today I'm saying something, I never know, maybe after a few days, I might start, I want to be like that only. I don't want to fix my belief system in a particular ways. I want to try because I want to make life my adventure. Everyone, if you make life your adventure every moment, by not going with the same habitual thinking that you've been carrying on, because it worked for you at that time, no. Creative ideas, new ways, let me try a new route. Let me try a new way of thinking. That's creativity, then it's joy, then it's fun, then it's boring. And life cannot be boring at all. You'll have so many experiences then, so many people you meet. Otherwise, if you want to be in a comfort zone, please don't. Try something, come out of that. Don't worry, nature is there to help you. Everyone is there to help you. Have that faith, develop that faith. And then you see how your life is. Amazing results. You know, you become a boundless cup of, manifestation too, and energy that you start, radiating to everyone. The spark that you give to everyone, they get a smile on their face, a loving hug also, becomes so good and wonderful. Before that, it was like, finish my formality and go. But now with love, you really enjoy it. You're being there. You feel that person, what the person is saying, because you're aware. Aware every moment. You understand the importance, sensitivity, every person. You go deeper into that self because you know your deep self. That's why the answer for everything is meditation. The more you meditate, wonderful your life becomes. All this also like it's just, when you come to a stage like the beginning, okay, you want all this, you carry to this level. You come to a state where you're happy with whatever things are happening, you just move. Because you know everything is right for you, designed for you. Then every moment, every sorrow, every hurt, every celebration, every memory that you have had in the past or in the future, every moment, is actually a perfect design of the Creator. You look back at the weaving and the tapestry and cry over it. What a beauty. And that's why I say, love each other, every other, even your enemies whom you call as prosecutors. Just do that. Bless all. Make your life filled with gratitude. You know what I do when I get up in the morning? As soon as I put my feet down, I say, I'm grateful to God for all the beautiful gifts of life. I'm grateful to God for brushing. I'm grateful. Everything. I keep on doing this to God. And then I change another affirmation. I'm a white divine light, radiating white light to all. Okay? Some affirmations are very favorite of mine. Keep on saying that. If someone is a little angry, then I send violet flame to that person. I say that her thoughts are good. She's happy. Send blessings. Just listen to that person, not get affected. Keep sending those blessings to that person. After some time, the person's thought subsides, becomes normal, and you walk away, move away. You know how to stop and say. Sometimes, you have to disagree. You have to to agree to disagree, and then you say.
Great.
Okay, understanding, agree to disagree, you don't have to argue. The person is going on argumenting, he wants to prove that he is right. Okay, fine. Alright. Then you don't struggle to prove yourself. Because let us realize that we are not thoughts, we are not emotions, we are not even the body, we are beyond that. Come to this realization. And then a sudden joy will come. You jump out in ecstasy and knowing that, oh God, I am not the thought, I was thinking all the while that I am thought, I am this, I am this, I am this, you are labeling yourself. And beyond this, I am something more immeasurable, something more indestructible, something more beautiful and divine, you can immortal I call it. That cannot be explained, that cannot be expressed, that has to be felt. Feel that. Everyone, just feel that. It's a beautiful feeling, wonderful feeling. When you come to that feeling, don't even start meditating, you start knowing yourself. And then, what do you really want in your life also gets manifested. And if, even if it doesn't, know, wow, thank you. Okay, it becomes like this. You know,
you should thank Eric Gauntlet for that.
Yeah,
for
absolutely.
The you know it. Let us repeat, wow.
Wow, thank you so much. So great.
Wow.
Thank you.
I have failed. Wow.
Thank you.
I have succeeded. Wow.
Thank you.
Both the ways, every moment is absolutely fine. Remember this. Every person in this world, whatever is happening, at every moment is absolutely correct. When you understand this, no, then you will not cry. No struggles of fulfillment. No kind of a identity of the path that gives you. No, not at all. Because you're not going in the past, nor future, because both are illusion. Now. Just being the now, all struggle dissolves. Absolutely. So just be in that moment. And more in that moment, more methods of this will apply it and start living that life. We call about living in meditation, sir, you know about that, right? Living in meditation, that means what are we doing right now, like I'm, you know, giving a lecture. I'm completely in it. Nothing else comes to my mind. Just enjoying this. Being, state of being. You're eating, you're enjoying every morsel of your food, you know, the taste, the chewing, everything. So in every, when you become aware of your breath, of your body, of your actions and your thoughts and fears, every moment that you're aware about it, then what happens, like, you won't have to actually meditate at that time. Because you are living in meditation. You come to know that now you are what? Shiva. Or something that is beyond that. I am is a realization that comes beyond the mind, not from the limitation. So that becomes a living in meditation. Every moment from there, you become a thankful.
Govinda!
Put it in a silent mode.
Okay, we have another method called as absolute method. The absolute method is talking about what we call as the divine, God, no? When this few lines talk about God is bliss, unbounded love, infinite intelligence and harmony. Okay, when you say this, and visualize a picture of a person that you want to be, you send that person. What will happen? Thoughts that you've talked about God, you will, that rays goes into that person's soul. Okay, and that person gets healed. So have an image of your person that you really want in a deeply relaxed state. Think of the divine being bliss, absolute harmony, boundless love, infinite intelligence. Then see what happens. All that you've talked about to God is actually is going to that person with everything, with health, wellness, everything. So you can pray for people through the absolute method. And remember, when you pray for others, no, you don't have to pray for yourself. Then. You really don't have to. Why? Reason again?
You're part of that.
So part of that, what you give, you get back, no? You're praying for them, so what will you get back? By default. So by wasting energy on praying for yourself, pray for others, serve others. That make that your mission. In whatever ways, you will be served automatically. Okay. We finish with this, then we have affirmation. This affirmative method is almost same like, you know, you're affirming, okay, like a decree method, that sentences that it has to be. So you say with that sentence that, you know, like when there was an incident, like a person, a girl, you know, she didn't want to go along with one of her boyfriend, and so she wanted to split from him. But he was nagging, you know, he was trying to make her you know, pulling, you know, bullying her also at times, you know. So she got fed up. So what she did, she followed this method. Okay, by I release him, I release myself from him. He's also in the right place, I'm also in the right place, both of them. She just said that, affirming every day, and after a few weeks, absolutely, she wonders where this person has disappeared, like, mm-hmm. you know. So that's the magic, that power thought. When you give it complete power, no, it works. And people say it works, sometimes take months and years. Why do you think it happens like that?
So your own belief system.
Your own belief system, no? Because you think, no, this cannot happen in 1 month. But somewhere you have to be a little...
experiment yourself.
Yeah,
actually.
Experiment yourself. But you cannot say, like, you talk about, say you want $1 million in 1 month. It's something not very...
little logical also.
Logical. Somewhere you have to be very specific, also know that, yeah, it would come in the coming time. That sentence could be, you know, so there you have to use your common sense also, and you know actually everybody has a different kind of thoughts and dreams. Nobody thinks alike, so it's better, right? That's why the whole creation is for a different purpose for everyone. Not everybody wants money, no? Not everybody wants good relationship, because you already have. Okay, so we all have different, so for everyone there is enough, abundant. Just know that you are made to come on this earth to live a happy life. God the director has given you roles to play, but don't meddle with it. You know, do what he's trying to say through your intuitions, through your gut feelings, through your inner voice that is talking to you. Because that says, that only says what is right and wrong. You might get the inner voice whispers, you know, it's small little. Don't do this. Then the mind works, ego, manipulation. It sees the deals, no? And your heart says, no, I should be doing that. Okay? Mind says, oh God, be selfish, play money in world, think about it, don't spend on her. Conflict goes on. You start listening to heart, it's better, you think more better. Even your face, facial, you know, form also takes up. You become that kind of a person. Start looking that way, you become crude, or, you know, your facial expression also becomes like that. So just remember your, how your thoughts are. Start manifesting good thoughts, you know, it's wonderful to be living like that, because then you will not have any kind of physical ailment, no diseases, nothing would come to you, no mental conflicts, everything. That means we're connecting what? We're healing body, mind, spirit. Healthy body, healthy mind and spirit. As we learn from sir, that 10% of output you get when you work through physical body and 20 from mind and 70 from spirit. Just imagine when you work through your spirit, 70% output, you're not really straining yourself. And so many things could be done. No, so powerful you become then. So work through your spirit. That's the only thing you're supposed to do. Okay? So this is what, just give you one incident about how the mental healing had been done. His father was, you know, suffering from tuberculosis and his lungs were badly damaged. Okay? So what did he do? He planned to heal his father. So he lied to his father, just an argumentative, another method, like he was, this reminded me, ninth one. Argumentative method, that means trying to explain the person that why the belief system is there, that's why it isn't working. Okay? So he explained to his father that I got this particular ring from a monk, and this ring has a lot of healing power, it can heal you immediately. Okay, he said that. And he gave it to his father. Okay, and the father believed that, yeah, he got this. He immediately, you know, snatched from his hand and rubbed on his chest. Okay, for 2 weeks he did that with faith that this particular ring will heal him. And actually, the report said that his is completely healed. And actually, it was not that he purchased that from a man. It was actually bought from some printer that good. He went to a jeweler, put an ordinary stone only. Okay, and gave it to his father, saying that, you know, he got it from a monk. Because his father believed that the monk only has a special power, and that's why, you know, this has come. So with that kind of belief system, you work through his father. Okay, that's why when you say, you know, certain thing works for you, it's actually the faith that you have in the thing that works for you. Okay, so that's the healing took place in him. Okay, and there's so many stories I can't tell you, because how these manifestations took place. I would just like to end up with, you know, a nice thought, or you could say, like, we all could, you know, grow into spiritual flowers. Now, as you know, the physical flower has food, color, form, fragrance, right? Same, if we grow under the spiritual garden that we call divine, and we as spiritual beings, okay, over the time, we take this form, color, and fragrance. Okay, you start doing